Welcome to StarSync Tracker's learning series on Siril, Basic Post-Stack Processing. To start, we need to have an already stacked image. If you would like a tutorial about how to stack with Siril, see the video in the link below. First, open the stacked image that was made by Siril or another stacker like DeepSky Stacker or Sequator. Depending on how it was stacked, you may have a black image in the preview. This is because it is not stretched. You can switch between different quick stretch previews using the drop-down at the bottom of the controls. Most of the time you will probably use only three of them: linear, auto stretch, and histogram. Linear preview shows how the image would be saved, and you would typically use this view after you use histogram transformation to stretch your image for real. Auto stretch preview will usually show a more pleasing view of your image if you've not stretched it yet. It is useful when you want to do changes before doing the real histogram stretch itself. Histogram preview does a more extreme stretch so you can see what data is there. On top of the image preview are tabs for each color channel, and also a RGB channel to view the image in color. If you click on the image processing button, a number of tools are available. Several of them you will find useful, such as histogram transformation, color calibration, and background extraction. There are two color calibration options: color calibration and photometric color calibration. Photometric calibration tries to plate solve against your image and use a database of star colors to correct the color in your image. To try to solve, Siril needs the approximate location your image is pointed at, the focal length of your scope or lens, and the camera pixel size. If all the data is not in the image metadata, you can enter it in yourself. Keep in mind the search object feature to make finding the coordinates of your image easier. Sometimes Siril cannot solve the field. This often happens on wide field images or images that have been stretched non-linearly. So if you want to try to use this feature, do so before applying a histogram transformation. If you continue to have issues with this method, you can use the normal color calibration tool as an alternative. To use the normal color calibration, you must select a background area and a light area. You must select the area using a color channel tab. Selecting an area in the RGB tab will not work. Select a background area in your image. Click Use Current Selection under Background Reference. Then click Background Neutralization. Next, select a light area in your image, such as an area in a nebula. Click Use Current Selection under White Reference. Then click Apply. You will want to do a histogram transformation at some point before saving your image. When doing a histogram transformation, you should be in the linear view mode. There is an auto stretch button in the dialog, which gives you a good starting point. And you can make further adjustments by moving the sliders. For some images, contrast-limited adaptive histogram equalization could bring out more details. You would need to play with the values to see what is best for your particular image. Color saturation may be a useful tool to better emphasize the color in your image. For some images, background extraction may help. You can generate background samples or pick areas manually. If selecting areas manually, be sure to select areas that do not contain your object or any nebulosity. There are several ways to save your newly processed image. You can right-click on the image when RGB tab is selected to save it in different formats. You can click the Save button at the top to save your FITS file. You can click the Save icon to save it as a different file name or format. Here, I'll save it as a 16-bit TIFF file to bring it into the GIMP or Darktable for further processing. Siril has a lot of features you can experiment with, but I hope this allowed you to understand the basics. Thank you for watching.